In this video from D4 Therapy, we will learn about bipolar 1 and 2 disorders. This video will go over the symptoms of mania and hypomania, the symptoms of depression, what is the difference between bipolar 1 and bipolar 2, and what are the changes made to this disorder in the DSM-5-TR. So this chart kind of gives a visual representation of how a mood for a person with bipolar disorder might look like. So depression takes them really low, hypomania spikes it up to like expansive, irritable mood, and then mania kind of like shoots it up off the chart, really hyperactive, expansive, happy mood, right? So looking at what are this difference in hypomania, the person have irritable mood, they have high energy, or very different from their previous behavior. However, it does not disrupt their life. On the other hand, for mania, they have expansive mood, they have irritable mood, they have high energy, and this change, this increased, increased activity causes disruption in their life. The symptom criteria for both bipolar 1 and bipolar 2 disorders are similar. I have divided them into a person's thought and their behavior. So their thoughts might look like they have inflated self-esteem and they're very grandiose. So they love themselves, love to talk about themselves, they're full of themselves. Flight of ideas and racing thoughts, which is like the person has way too many thoughts very fast. They're easily distracted. They're distracted by small little noises in the background or by the things that they see. The behaviors look like there is decreased need for sleep, so they can keep going, keep partying with very little or no sleep. They talk more, and then there's pressured to keep talking. So they think that they need to keep talking constantly. There is goal-directed activities. So suddenly the person wants to get a law degree, and they want to start a business, and they want to run a marathon all in the same week. And they're activities have high potential for painful consequences. So something like maxing out their credit card, buying a car that they can afford, or infidelity in their relationship. The duration criteria for mania is at least 1 week. So the person have to demonstrate the symptoms for at least 1 week or any duration if they were hospitalized or detained because of the disruptive behavior. And for hypomania, the change from previous behavior with expansive and irritable mood and high energy at least lasts for 4 days or more. Now let's look at depressive symptoms. There are 9 symptoms for depression, out of which 5 have to be present for at least 2 weeks. I have made an entire video for major depressive disorder, which will help you go over all these symptoms in more details. So please go check it out, and I have left it in the description below. Now, let's see how can we give a person a diagnosis of bipolar 1 versus bipolar 2. So for bipolar 1, at least one lifetime manic episode has been present, hypomania can be present, and depressive episode has occurred. For bipolar 2, however, there has never been a manic episode, hypomania is their primary symptom, and depressive episode has occurred. So that's the difference. That's how you determine bipolar 1 from bipolar 2. Now let's talk about what are the changes that has been made to the DSM-5-TR. So criteria B for bipolar 1 has changed and criteria C for bipolar 2 has changed. There is a slight change in the language of how these criteria are now written. Initially in 5, they would write it as not better explained by schizoaffective disorder. Now it is changed to not better explained by schizoaffective disorder and is not superimposed on schizophrenia. This is to improve clarity of language. Another change that has happened is to the severity specifier of bipolar 1 disorder. So in DSM-5, the severity specifiers did not actually align or were not cohesive with the symptoms of mania. So previously, the mania severity was described as mild, moderate, and severe, and the descriptions said that symptom result in minor impairment in social or occupational functioning, which kind of disqualifies mania from this description, because mania requires that the person's functioning is disrupted to a level that it causes like impairment in social and occupational functioning. So this was like not cohesive. Hence, they added a new set of descriptions for the severity. So the mild one now states that minimum symptom criteria are met for a manic episode. Moderate one would say that very significant increase in activity or impairment in judgment. And severe says that almost continuous supervision is required to prevent physical harm. It is important to remember, though, that the change does not apply to the depressive episodes. For depressive episodes, the specifier remains the same as the one on the left-hand side. If you have found this video to be helpful, please consider liking and subscribing. Thank you for watching.